It's Sunday, 24th of January, and I've got to see how much work I could get done before Monday morning. I've got to put holes in those three little pieces, waiting for Monday morning, where I've got to get holes in these before the end of the month. That's Inconel 718. I've got a right task on. I've got to see how much work I can get done today. So it's 7 a.m. I better crack on. First thing, I've got to strip the machine down and get it ready for whichever job I decide I'm doing first. Let me get all this junk off of here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Right, I'll get set up for the inking hole for Monday morning. This is just a rough bore. Monday morning. And I'm on with the ink canal. 192mm bore, 50 inches long. Well, that wasn't so difficult. It's got a quarter of an inch to go to break through. Easy peasy. Well, this one's a little bit different. It's 8 inches longer. And it's not a 192mm bore. Can you see what I've been doing over there on the Bridgeport? So the last one was 192mm. So that's the tool coming out. And that's the tool gone in. 11 1/4 inch. I've slowed the res down, obviously. 58 inches long. Ink and all, 718. Well, the reason I had it in the Bridgeport was to do some alterations to it. I've milled it so it takes the Tufnell pads what I use, which are very successful. And I've deepened the scrap channel for the inner cartridge. I've used this tool before and it's rubbish. Hopefully it'll run better. Well, I told you it was rubbish. It's gone 9 inch and broke 3 inner cartridges. The wall thickness of the tube's too thin. It's 14mm and it should be 16mm. I'm going to take this tool out and put another one in. This is a tool I've got to use. I'm super annoyed. This one's 14mm wall thickness too. It's supposed to work miracles here with absolute dinosaur tooling. I'll mill them in and see how I go on with it. I'll turn it around at the other end. That's both pad pockets done for the Tufnell pads. I'll change these old cartridges, put new ones in, and then give it a try. Wish me luck. Well, I was gonna start it, but look. The cartridge is set back from the face. And the scrap channel's not milled right. I'm getting really. I'm not gonna swear, but you know what I'd like to say. I'm going to weld it up and get it back on Miller. This is ridiculous. Right, that's back on centre line. I'll show you it when it's done. I've done all I can with it. All I can do is try. I'm not going to hold my breath. I've just done it 30 inches deep. That's what I need to go to get to halfway on that job. If it works, it'll be a miracle. And I'm going to change my name to Jesus. Mind you, he could only turn water into wine, not John Smith. Absolute total failure. Didn't even go 1 inch. I'm going to turn it round so there's 40 odd inch to go, but it's with a tool that I've made. Getting quite desperate here, so I'm going to try that. Well, that's gone 25 inches now without stopping, without changing the inserts. Just the difference with a decent tool. Doesn't take much for them not to work, and doesn't take much for them to work exceptionally well. Let's just see how long I can keep it going. It's got 16 and a half inches left to go. Carbide's failed. I'm going to turn it round. What you're going to see next, you won't have seen before. I'll be trepanning the core, what was left from the last tool. There's the core from the last tool. It's 250 millimeter, and this tool is 230. 10 millimeter wall tube will come out of it. So you can see what's going to happen. It's just got 3 inches left to go. I'll be glad when this is out of the way. Look at that, a core in a core. It's done.